series. So the voting is still open. You can vote for Yapzor with exclamation mark MVP 1, vote for Limp with exclamation mark MVP 2, Loda MVP 3, Cinnamon MVP 4, and then Koikfa is MVP number 5. And it will run the entire series, and it is not a popularity vote, even though some
clearly.
People treat it like that.
Clearly.
Yeah.
Looks like my prom vote, dude. Jesus.
Your prom vote?
Yeah, you know.
I don't even know what that is.
Prom king? Prom
into the draft! Okay. We don't do that in the Netherlands.
Why? Oh, what do you guys do for prom? Everyone...
We don't have prom. There's no prom.
That explains a lot.
Okay, into the draft we go. Welcome also back. Only picks one god that will help us out. Dissecting this draft.
Oh, god,
we have a
no.
Skid Gaming on the Dire side. They ban out the Duro and a Darkseer and the Invoker and a Batrider. Banned out by Alliance, who open with a Mirana and a Naga Siren.
Hey.
Everybody loves a Naga Siren, right, guys?
Hey, it's the best time to have a Naga. Naga games can be fun. The words from Aoi 2000 when we interviewed him. Everyone hates Naga except the guy playing it. The sadistic bastard who makes 9 people's lives miserable. So, gotta respect that Naga player as a techies player myself. I do love those evil bastards, so I'm happy for him. Let him have the Naga gods.
Sure. Like you say, it's in the, we're in the morning, you know. If this was 2 in the morning, I see that Naga pick, I'm like, oh god, why are you doing this Alliance? why not?
We got all day for Dota.
Yeah.
Let's have some Naga. That sounds great. Alright, but anyway, Escape Gaming, they're going to pick up a Ogre McGee and a Sand King. Already seeing a lot of lockdown, and not looking too good on that, but Mirana, she don't care. She'll be alright, right? Good?
Could be alright. I mean, flexible, could be support, could be mid, could be offlane, you know? You don't really know where this series is going to be going when you pick it up early on in the draft, so.
Yep.
Does leave things open, has the nice power out of the sleep combo. And I guess in theory you could say Naga, you don't know if it's a core or a support, but we're seeing almost exclusively core Naga Siren.
Yeah, I mean, 2 things to watch out here. They already banned the Alchemist, so they want to bring it late game, most likely. And then just say, you know, Alchemist is probably one of the only guys that could beat a Naga. Will we see another Wisp picked up, though? We did see a Wisp Naga the other day as, like, some support on that hard carry Naga. Think that could happen again?
Alliance. I mean, they, EGM and Hanskin both play great Wisps, so definitely possibility. If they want to do a support Mirana, I would say no, but could be a core Mirana with a support IO. It's pretty good at getting people out if they get initiated on by a Sand King, for example. So.
Yeah.
Nobody wants to face a Naga Siren in the late game. So Escape Gaming's got to kind of go all in early to mid game, right?
You think so?
I would say so.
Likely they want to go for... They want to have heroes that can push out lanes and also maybe 5-man and push high ground kind of in the early stages. Alternatively, you take the approach where they go Naga, we're going to pick an Anti-Mage or something.
Sure. You're going to go head-to-head, I guess, but I like that creative Pugna that we saw yesterday as a Naga answer. Quick, easy to illusion.
Yeah.
They didn't win, but
it did very well.
Yeah, I mean, it wasn't that bad.
It's not really a typical thing that Escape Gaming, that we have not seen it from them yet.
No.
But they could decide to try it out. I'm not sure if this is the place where you want to try out anything.
Sure though, you
do. There are tournament lives that are on the line, and the loser of this series is taking third place in the Aces RG Dream League, and Escape's already 1 game down, so 1 more loss, and they are out.
How sad. We love both these teams here.
Very sad.
Oh, we're going to see Hanskin.
Oh yeah, baby.
So with some very, very good performance yesterday.
Are you sure it's Hanskin playing it, though?
Could be the Limp. No, but Hanskin Disruptor, we saw him play incredibly yesterday. They did not win that game, but they just dominated it. They got that Terrorblade down to 5 HP yesterday. The entire game would have been different if they killed him before he sundered.
I wonder if Escape just go for the third peak jug. You know what I mean? It's there.
Sure.
It's good against Disruptor.
Does anyone on Escape play jug, though? Has Era ever played jug before?
Only a couple thousand times.
it's a hero.
I mean, we did see Quota play a previous game.
Oh, yeah, hey!
So, you know, they did switch it up a little bit.
And he could play Lifestealer instead. That could be something else that they looked up for.
Lifestealer's not great against Naga strats.
Yeah.
Win fast, because Lifestealer's really bad at pushing out lanes.
So they could go for something like the Lifestealer, the Slaughter combo, but then again, I don't think we've seen Trixie play Slaughter on the offlane.
Yeah, I think he's likely playing the Sand King.
I like the ODP for Koifa. You get Koifa's hero now, it's something to help deal against the Naga illusions. And I think that's a strong pick from Escape Gaming.
Hell yeah, dude.
But at the same time, a good disruptor play can abuse an OD. You know, you got to be careful with those defensive Astrals and such, because Hanscan is going to be there with the follow-up.
There's also still Nyx Assassin in the pool, which is where picking that third was dangerous. They could have picked it fourth, and then banned out Nyx if they wanted to. But
hello.
Not Nyx.
I like this mix-up that they're doing, you know? We said that they wanted to do a late-game draft on Alliance, they've been banning like that, but then they throw it in an Undying, which kind of gives them a lot of early-game presence against Escape Gaming, but... I mean, what is really Tombstone going to do here? They got a couple... They got Sandstorm, they got...
Yeah.
Whatever... What do you call when OD puts them in the other dimension?
The Astral Imprisonment.
Astral Imprisonment.
I mean, I still feel that, but then Dying is, like... Sure, you pick the jug for error. I mean, you've got something that you can Blade Fury hit down the tombstone while you're under the safety of it.
Yeah, jug still seems fine. Yeah. Good against Glimpse because you can just Blade Fury away. You can go Battle Fury build as far as being able to push out.
I guess the only thing is that Naga versus jug interaction that they may be a little hesitant about picking the jug into, but other than that, there's a lot of reasons for error to want to just play the Juggernaut again this game.
Yeah, you want. Want to be able to push out lanes, but Jug can do that. It just means you have to go Battle Fury.
Well, still, as well, Warlock's still in the pool. If they want to run Trixie Sand King and throw Sind on the Warlock this game.
So Trixie played Sand King in the first series they had this tournament.
I mean, this is the pick that I think everyone watching would have expected Escape Gaming to go for there.
Unless they felt like they had to change their draft radically to beat Alliance, which I think these two teams very evenly match. Shouldn't be the case. Just stick with the hero. It's good against Disruptor, good against Undying. It's not great against Naga, but it's not terrible. So, works out fine. Gives him some push and some 5-man with the OD Jug. Just drop a Healing Ward, Jug hits buildings, OD sits behind, giving everyone the aura.
I still really would like to see Escape finish off with that Warlock pick. I feel that nice here.
Depending who the air is on the Ogre.
They ban out the Enigma. I can't remember the last time we saw an Enigma ban, but interesting.
Whoa, come on, you gotta ban out Enigma against Escape Gaming. They play a fantastic Enigma, a game changer.
Yeah, I mean, Yapzor can.
I think when you're versing the Naga, often you want to have a good, greedy 4 position to farm with, because if it's going to be a long game, you want a 4 position hero that can farm a lot. And that's where Ogre's not really that hero, so there's a good chance we see Sind on the Ogre and you pick something for Yapzor that can take farm, which could have been Enigma. We've seen him do it on other heroes as well. Some greedy Midas pickups have come out from the supports from time to time. Had a Pudge, that was a lot of fun. Was it Midas Pudge that he went for?
Oh, I like that. Final ban as well against Alliance. Yeah, that would be playing it so much.
Not again!
I mean, going late game against a Prophet Naga as well could be pretty, pretty terrifying.
Absolutely.
If they get their timings. So Escape Gaming, you not want to deal with that.
Sure.
And this final pick? I'd like to see the Warlock. Anything else that you kind of feel comes to mind? Yapzor Clock, also something if they want to start to create the chaos early on. They want to get the push on.
Do get the jungler and the push, It's like the Alliance style draft, you know, Jug Chen going on, Ogre, got the Aura. Dang, this is a lot of 5-man push. They do want to make sure they can try win the game before Naga gets too scary. I think if you're Alliance looking at like a teamfight hero to stop that push, something that can benefit from the sleep setup perhaps a bit, get some more AoE teamfight going in. Because both Naga as well as Morana do need quite a bit of farm to work.
That's
who that's going to be.
Easiest Clinks pickup of my life, dude. Eat the Chen creeps, big early game damage, about it. Better question, Astral Imprisonment. Why?
Anyone else got any other
I mean, that's kind of bad for, you know, the prison systems of the world. You go into prison, come out hurting.
What about Jonas and Fam playing Axe this game? Axe and Dying Lane.
Yeah, Legion Commanders, good deep push.
No, they're taking their time.
Or the team fights like your Void, your Tides, but...
It's something that you're going to be able to kind of fight as four and just, as you said, create space for the Naga.
Axe is really good versus Jug, just because you blink on him, you play Mal, and Jug kind of just kills himself.
Axe...
We saw that with Loda.
He could have a hard lane matchup if they managed to switch it around and get SK against him, but... Jonas and Fan Axe is something that he's very, very strong with. Yep. They've obviously got versatility still with the heroes, they could kind of throw a bit of a curveball, switch around the cores. The players.
Yeah, they could put
Alliance.
They could run the Naga mid in theory and pick up like a fighting carry, like a gyrocopter type hero. That's a hero they've been playing a lot of, but I don't think you want Naga mid versus OG particularly. that Miranda does okay enough. You can at least, it's a workable lane, it's not a good lane by any means.
I mean, how's Lib Sniper? You know, is that something that they could sneak through and play against the OD?
Okay, and Strapler's not bad against the push, but also not amazing. Playing Sniper against Sanking is a bit rough, but...
Yeah, I guess once he gets a blink, it's a bit of a nightmare.
Yeah, and then Jug gets a blink as well. And...
It's the Axe. I really like this. I really like this. Jonas and Fan Axe. He's... Yep. I remember a lot of games where he has had an absolutely fantastic performance on that. I really like what Alliance has done there with that final pick.
So you'd say Alliance?
Yeah, Axe dying, it can be absolutely devastating. If it goes late, they've got the backup with the Naga. I like it.
Okay, guys, how about you?
It's a good last pick. I think it was the right hero, but yeah. I still prefer the Escape draft overall. With the Chen, the five-man, the OD Jug, I want to side with Escape on this.
I'm gonna have to go with Lions. Yeah, not a big fan of the Chen. Sorry. I feel like you can deal with it.
I don't particularly like the hero, Naga Siren, but I do think that she's gonna win. So okay. I'm going with the Lions as well. Let's hear from our commentators though. It is time for game two, Escape versus Alliance with Annie and Fog.
10 seconds remaining. Prepare for battle.
Thank you very much, my lovely panel. I am here with Fogged, and we are about to see our second Naga game together. What are your feelings about that?
I'm kind of okay with seeing Naga early. You know, early on in the day, I'm cool with this. I think one nice thing that they have going on with this Naga thing is they have multiple different heroes that work well with the sleep. So they have Static Storm with the kinetic field on top of sleep. They have the Tombstone, which obviously builds up the zombies, and then of course they have the Arrow, which can be timed properly with the Song of the Siren once he gets to that point if he wants to be getting involved a little bit early, since obviously Escape is looking for this push lineup. So I think Escape has to watch out once Alliance hits all their level sixes and being sure they're not clumped up while they're pushing a tower, because they might just get caught off guard by all these, like, by this easy setup into such massive team fight potential. But other than that, Escape has a very, like, early game push strategy, obviously, like, group up with the Chen, that's their like, idea, but it's going to be a lot of pressure on Yapzor in order to do that, because, you know, they're playing versus the Naga Siren. They luckily have the Sand King, which deals very well versus Illusions once you get that Aghanim's online, obviously, that's what people were doing for a bit, but I have been seeing Trixie struggle a bit on this hero, and OD, of course, actually does match up quite well versus Naga to clear out the Illusions, but I'm a bit torn. I think it's it really depends a lot on this early game, it depends a lot on this Chen's movements, but I'm liking Alliance's.
I like Alliance's draft. Again, game number one, they looked so dominant, but I don't think Escape's going to give up that easy. I think they still got something up their sleeve. I think they're feeling confident going into game number two. Again, this is Escape's last chance to stay in the tournament. They have to win this game, or they are out. Limp, going to be moving in towards the mid lane. How's this mid going to go? Usually Quakeva doesn't have a whole lot of trouble dominating the mid, but against a Mirana, might be a little difficult.
He's just going to be arrowing range creep every single time, guaranteeing that CS to get the experience, obviously, but OD overall, it's fairly even. I think OD maybe comes out just a little bit ahead because you can Astral and get a couple denies in, but Mirana can always arrow to guaranteed CS, so yeah, it's a bit of a trade. Bottom lane, Trixie getting pressured very hard by the Decay and the Thunderstrike, so they're making sure they do this tri-lane to just force out the Ogre and Sand King. And this is something we saw people doing and adjusting with a lot with this Undying. When Ogre's picked up, they match it up with an Undying, and they just follow the Ogre around the entire time just to kind of put him down a bit.
I mean, Cinderin, we saw last game, he was just riding the struggle bus with that Ogre. He just couldn't stop dying. He was trying to set up for his team. He played a very mobile early game, but after that, he just didn't have a huge impact. Do you think we're going to see a similar style of Ogre this game, or will it definitely be the hero that Escape need?
It's just an Ogre in a draft. Like, he's gonna be this, like, walking bloodlust in a fashion. I think it's a lot more focused on this Chen, you know? It's really on Yap sort of making this moves and how they group up properly in this, because they even have a free farming Jug. He's actually laning versus nobody. Jonas just wants the jungle for now, but he's gonna be picking up his TP, he's got a salve, he's got a stout shield, he's got a fairy fire. Maybe we'll probably see him be going up toward that top lane just to contest the era just a bit after he gets his level 3 already. Less than 2 minutes on the Axe.
Yeah, Axe is already starting things out pretty nicely, but a free-farming Juggernaut, that seems real scary. Is that something that Escape can let happen? Or rather, that Alliance can let happen?
Yeah, I mean, it all depends. It's really just so much on this gen. It's they do have OD, which matches obviously very well versus the Naga in later stages, but it's really dependent on how this laning stage comes out. And Alliance is doing just such a damn good job right now of zoning this Sand King Ogre. Sand King's level 2 now, but yeah, they're focusing super heavily on just being this zoning, giving this Naga the full free farm that they want. Even has a level net skill too, so in case they want to go for that kill potential.
Yeah, you talked about Escape having that early push lineup, and Alliance making sure that they don't get anything done early. There is going to be that Burrow Strike. Trixie trying to run away.
Got the glimpse.
Yeah, he's coming back into the damage, but is there enough? Oh, hell yeah, there we go. Alliance scores the first blood by getting down Trixie. Now, Cinder, and he's tanky enough to walk himself back to the tower, but I think this bottom lane is going to get tougher and tougher for Escape as the experience and the gold start pouring in for Alliance.
Yeah, they're committing the three heroes there, so at least they're split. Their Escape has the one thing going from that, where they're splitting experience in for three heroes, but getting kills is, I mean, that's exactly what they want to be happening, and then suiciding the Undying, and he's just going to be able to make his moves around where he decides to. Like I said, probably matching up versus the Ogre every single time, just because that's what people do. It's just very good to be following the Ogre around with the Undying. Hounskin now getting some pressure on him.
Yeah, I don't know if he gets out of this one. The net connects onto Trixie, but they've just got the right click damage. Cinderin scoring a kill for himself, getting at least a little bit of dominance back, allowing Trixie to feel safe.
Top lane.
Oh, they're going Jonas. Back in. Jonas is in some serious trouble, gets slowed down, and that's going to be a nice kill going the way of Era. So this Juggernaut getting exactly what he wants. He's got free farm, he's second on the CS chart, now a kill to his name.
Yeah, nice rotation by Yap. So we're picking up the little purge creep, the most obnoxious ganking creep ever, because you actually are just non-stop slowed. There's no way to get out of it unless you just TP if he doesn't have a stun. But Jonas didn't have a TP there, so he does get caught out a little bit. Just unexpected. Not really thinking that rotation would happen just that there. But yeah, great movement by Yapzor. Already almost level 5 on this Chen.
Yeah, I think you talked about it. The Chen is the key to this game, and you've got your Chen off to a great start. What else does Escape need to do to set themselves up for success in this early game?
I mean, they're just gonna keep laning, you know. It's very early. They're just, you know, they're just laning. Like it's fairly even. It's not like they're at a deficit yet at this point. So
Arrow moving forward. He's got his spin. He's fresh out of mana. Hellbear not gonna get there fast enough to clap and slid on the axe. So it's gonna be Axe walking back. This Axe has had a pretty tricky game so far.
Yeah, he's doing good on the CS board though. He's got boots. He's level 5 already. Iron Talon. Yapzor already level 5 as well, so he's gonna have that triple creep when he gets to find another one, a big one, but yeah, just keeping the pressure on, guaranteeing Era that he can farm freely. Bottom lane now, just get a little bit of pressure, they get the glimpse up on Trixie, he should be dead here for sure.
Yeah, there's no way he gets out of this one, still 3 seconds in the Burrow Strike cooldown against 3 heroes, it's not looking good, and Loda starting to scale up pretty nicely in terms of CS, gonna be 3rd on the board, but already having a couple kills there on that Naga 1-0-1.
Yeah, and he goes for the Arcane Boots. I like this a lot just because he's playing in a tri-lane. Sometimes you see them go for, like, just the raindrops into Aquila, but since he's playing inside of a hardcore tri-lane, he wants to be giving his buddies some more mana, but probably seeing him pick up, like, a Basti just so his guys get a little bit more bonus from that, as well as his mana movement. But as I say, he picks up a raindrop, so it's, you know, it's... That's the thing that some people like to do. They pick up the raindrop if there's lots of magic damage, and other people switch it up. Omni Slash coming out from Era picks up the solo kill, actually, on the Axe in the top lane.
Yeah, the Axe is really suffering, and Axe is one of those heroes that kind of has to get a good start to feel super powerful into the mid-game, and he is a huge initiator for Alliance. Yeah, they've got the Song of the Siren Naga, but, I mean, Axe, Blink, Call is going to be a really key point of how Alliance get these fights going.
Yeah, it's a big deal when he dies, too, just because they get so much pressure on the tower, but once this tower drops, he actually gets a lane to himself, so hopefully we'll see Escape pull it back once this tower dies, so that the Axe can't just free-farm.
Yeah, I was thinking about calling. Looks like it's just going to be Era trying to go in for the last hit on the tower. Deny. Will it come out? It will not. Juggernaut just raking in the gold right now down bottom. Some more initiation
bottom
coming
lane,
back in.
EGM.
Burrow Strike. Looks like EGM is just going to be going. He grabs himself up a little bit more HP. Cinderin still bopping him up, but the net comes in. In fact, Cinderin's probably going to be in trouble. The Tombstone.
There's a glimpse coming in from Houndskin.
Yeah, okay.
There you go.
This is looking like it's getting tougher and tougher for Escape. Cinderin dragged back in. He's got the kinetic field. He's going to try to TP out. The Hand of God coming in. Moonlight Shadow trying to keep the rest of Alliance safe and sneaky as they move the Marauder towards the mid lane. Limp will eventually help find the kill onto the Sand King. Ogre, though, he just skirts death at every turn there.
Yeah, the Ogre's surviving all these ganks. He gets the TP out there, too, but I think the one that needs to be surviving more so is the Sand King. They're focusing all their attention on him. And yeah, nice little Chen heal there to save the Ogre while he's TPing out, but yeah, losing their Sand King there is definitely not what you want. He's level 4. Jonas is already level 6 on the axe, so even though Jonas is dying, he's getting what he wants in the top lane. He's getting initiated on. Getting a bunch of spins, though. He gets the, oh my god, he almost gets the dunk on Era. That would have been huge, but nice little burst damage potential there from Yapzor with the creeps as well.
Yeah, dude, he's got his little petting zoo online. They are controlling up this top lane. I mean, can Alliance even fight in this top lane? Is it just Juggernaut's lane right now?
It's mostly Juggernaut's lane, but like I said, Axe is getting, he's getting kind of what he wants. He's dying, he's giving a bit too much farm, a little bit too much bonus farm to the Jug, but he's level 7, like, he's feeling good. Level 7 Axe compared to the Sanking was only level 4. It's not the worst.
Alright, I mean, our Naga Siren has the potential to scale late. Let's not forget that there is a Naga in this game played by Lota. This thing is going to carry hard. I mean, how long can a Juggernaut hold on against a Naga?
It depends on the item build, depends on the timings too. I wonder, I'm interested to see if we'll see Era maybe go for that Battle Fury build and try to take it to the later stages, or if he'll just do this standard mantle that we've been seeing a lot. Bottom lane.
Naga Siren chasing trouble. She's only level 5, does not have the song to bail her out of this undying, doing what he can. Trixie, he's getting low, the tombstone dropped out, but Lota still being hunted by Cinder in a couple more hits, and that will be a kill. But the short range arrow, Cinderin might actually be the one fighting Dust here. He does end up popping out the Observer Ward before he goes down, at least getting something for his trouble. There's a glimpse back in to the kinetic field. OD.
Based it on Coinkbo though, he should be okay. Just
Arrow
in 1 second, are they gonna be able to get it? No, they're not.
Yeah, Arrow moves in, he's got the threat of the Omni Slash, and that will be Alliance trying to back off. Hanskin's super, super low. Can Arrow catch up to this? Looks like he's trying, he's gonna be going under the tower of the Astral
dead to
hold the,
Astral. The
OD, or rather the Disruptor in place, the OD gets the kill.
Yeah. So great, I mean the raindrop pick up there for Lota actually saved his
Arrow's
life.
Arrow's not done. He's moving forward here. EGM's pretty gosh darn tanky, but with the OD on the backside, that Astral will score a double kill.
Yeah.
That's neat. Escape. They go in. They realize, all right, we won top lane super hard. Let's rotate. Let's do the same thing to bottom lane. And so far it's working. Axe finding a little bit of space to himself, but Alliance are going to be losing a second tower here.
Yeah, good rotation by Arrow there, though. But yeah, it gives Jonas a bit more space, and he's still doing pretty well. He's level 8. Like, his farm is catching up. He's not, like, very close to that blink just yet, but he's got the levels to be able to boost himself that farm at least. And, yeah, I mean, levels are very important on an Axe. And Trixie's still super, like, super struggling on this tanking. 0-4, only level 5. I think it's really important that DA try to get him back into this game because he's, very much so struggling.
Cinder, and he's camping towards that mid lane. Escape would love to find a pick on that Barana, because that's someone on Alliance that has been pretty much unchecked, having a very nice game. Smoke gank coming in. There's going to be Alliance ready to start mounting a defense. Killing Trixie off again would be pretty crippling, but Escape, they've got the resources necessary to turn this if it does turn into a brawl.
And they're just losing all their towers though. Like, Yapzor is putting in big work with his creeps, with Era, just constantly pushing down towers.
That's what you expect with a Chen.
Yeah, I mean, he's doing the, I mean, it's, you know, he's just making the right rotations though, and he's going for that Aghanim's rush that we do see, I think, a lot of people doing, but I think Lil is the one who's been doing it more often since they're the few people who've been picking Chen, and it puts a lot of pressure on just pushing the lanes out constantly.
Tier 2 falling to the Chen army, and now Era with his buddies. They're going to start to pressure Tier 3s. We are 10 minutes into the game. Wildwing Ripper popping out that tornado, just getting some going, and I like that dominating the Siege Creek, just bringing a little bit more push back in. Now Lota is going to be ready to go and defend this. Still, no song at level 6 does not pick it up.
Nah, that troll.
Yeah, get that troll hit. Oh, you got the Siege Creep. I like how it turns back into a Dire Creep when it's dead.
That was actually really weird. Yeah, I saw that too. I was like, what the hell? Jonas, top lane, getting gone on. He's got the TP. Cinderin's got the stun, though. Jonas going to be dropping down here for sure.
I mean, if he spins like 40 consecutive times, maybe he could turn this. Nope, he's dead.
He is dead.
He's super dead. And now mid lane, just more pressure being added in.
Mirana ults coming in.
Looking at the defense here, but Escape, they've got a ton of space. This is feeling very much like Alliance Game 1, where they just start out the game strong, they get their cores rolling, and all of a sudden, what do? You just kind of got to walk around and react. Alliance is playing a very reactive game. They're not the ones making the first moves. They're not the ones going in for the initiations. They're just trying to stay alive when Escape jumps them.
Yeah, great rotations by Yapzor, and even very good aggressive wards. They put in 2 wards into the Alliance jungle just to keep vision of what's going on and just be able to farm the jungle a bit freely and just keep the pressure going.
Yeah, of course, Alliance. They've got a Naga Siren, so at no point in the game, even at Mega Creeps, can we tap them out. In fact, Mega Creeps are probably the staple of Alliance games. So Alliance don't feel super scared. They can take this late. They can just kind of wait till Chen and his army lose a little bit of relevance, till Alliance have the tools to easily clear out his creeps.
Yeah, they still didn't want to lose, like, you know, four towers. Like,
it's
two tier 2s
ideal.
Already by the 10-minute mark. Definitely hurts. But, yep.
Oh, Hanskin.
In a bit of a... Ooh, oh, nice little
fancy
play.
Blades. He realizes he is in some deep doo-doo and is able to TP out. That's an expensive TP, but it will keep him alive.
I mean, they sent Arrow home. I guess they thought there was going to be more backup there. But yeah, he's got the TP. He's going to go toward the mid lane. Time to push another tier 1. And Lions can't really contest until they have this Axe, Blink Dagger, or if they want to bring the Naga in for the sleep, but they have no way of doing that now since the Static Storm is on cooldown.
It's looking tough. Overall, net worth split, you've got 3 out of the top 4 heroes on the side of Escape Gaming, and they're showing no signs of giving in. OD and Juggernaut can scale well into the late game, you know, 40-50 minutes. They could still be on the top of the charts, of course. Once Naga picks up her real big split push items, it's going to change things up, but Naga is not even close to that Radiance yet.
Yeah, and you know, Trixie was struggling a lot, but what's a better way to get a person back into the game other than taking 6 towers?
Yeah, that works.
Yeah, that works. Yeah,
that's a strategy. Dota 2.
Mm-hmm. Beating on tier 2 again, so that's another one. They're gonna have Hurricane Pike finished up on Koifa any moment now, top lane. Oh. Trixie.
Yeah, I think Trixie's dead again. That is kind of the one thing Alliance got going on for them. There is gonna be Shen trying to do Shen things, but
now they
not
got the blink on the Axe whenever he goes back. Get up. But Escape continuing the pressure.
Tombstone popped out behind the tier 2. This is a very defensive play from Alliance. They're just trying to force everyone back. Look at the zombies crawling around, but Arrow has no trouble dealing with this with his healing ward. Arrow shooting on through is just going to graze on past the ogre. Moonlight Shadow coming in. It's EGM. He wants to continue this hunt. The rest of his team, they're pretty far behind him. They're trailing, and aside from the Axe Blink, they don't have a whole lot of mobility.
Yeah. Koifa forces the sleep bottom from Lotus, so now it's 180 seconds throughout, 3 minutes without the Song of the Siren. And yeah, they claimed all the tier 2s now from Escape, so up to the next couple plays that they want to do, maybe go for a Roche pretty soon after they get some deep wards, make sure the lanes are nicely pushed out before they go for that, but yeah, it's about, where do they go from here? That's what they gotta be thinking, you know, they can't just like sit back and let Alliance catch up after all this, because sure they got the towers, but breaking high ground is a whole different monster.
Yeah, man, Alliance thrive on this game going late. The OD and the Jug are still scary, but I believe in Lota. I think he can do it. And again, Escape, they've got to win this game or they are out of Dream League. This is going to be it. The winner of the series moves on to the Grand Final versus Liquid. So it's all on the line here. Now, 2 Magic Sticks for Disruptor. Neat.
Yeah, sometimes, you know, sometimes you just make that little mistake. You buy it when you're dying and you're like, wait.
You know, one for each hand who just cast and spells left and right.
He'll notice.
I think he's noticed.
If he notices yet.
I feel like he would notice if that's in your inventory slot. All right, dropping one. Now there is going to be the Roche coming out. Nice and early for Escape. They've definitely got the damage to take it. And Alliance, this is a very classic trade. They're going to go in for the top tier 2 while the Roche is going out.
Yeah, they're going a bunch of little early game items. Arrow went for the straight S and Y Rush. Koifa, you know, standard on OD, goes for the Hurricane Pike. And yeah, they're going to get to claim this Roche completely uncontested, but you know, this is a trade that I feel like we see all too often. The Roche for the tier 2 top, and that is what's happening. The reason actually, Limp is actually putting pressure on the mid lane tower too, and he's pretty close to his Aghanim Scepter on top of that.
Yeah, that Mirana's really going to start to bring the magical damage, and so far Escape don't have a lot of solutions for that. I mean, OD can go and Astral someone, and Jug can spin, but Escape are still pretty vulnerable to big bursts.
Yeah, they've got the Hand of God, but yeah, Chen did not go for the Mac like we were mentioning. He went for this Aghanim split push aura build, obviously. So, yeah, there it goes.
So Alliance starting to make themselves a little worthwhile. They lose both towers in their top lane, but they're able to go through and take both of Escape's towers at a pretty decent time. I mean, we are only 15 minutes in the game. It feels deceptively late with all the push that's been coming out.
Relic finished up for Lota. This is their time to start getting the farm on, making sure that they push the waves out, and making sure that they just can't...
Hey, found his blink!
Nice. Yeah, they just can't... So it's really important that EGM does not die anywhere outside the base. He knows this. He's just going to sit in the base. He has to be very keen on making sure that he just defends the high ground at his best possible positioning with pretty much like everybody else, actually, because they just... I mean, they don't want to lose Arax, obviously, so they need this game to be prolonged quite a bit longer for this Naga to get online. Escape, though, mounting the pressure. All 5 heroes coming down, Trixie picking up his Blink Dagger as you mentioned, and this is go time. frenzy on the Juggernaut in the front
Era
lines.
Drops lower than he meant to in that fight, just really, really vulnerable to all of this. It's going to be spinning so he doesn't get glimpsed back up onto the high ground, does not go down there. Arrow going to be skirting on through. It takes out a Chen Centaur, but nothing that Escape can't deal with. They're going to continue to slow siege here, just clearing out the wave, maybe trying again as the next Dire creeps move in.
Yeah, they still kind of have to watch out if they stack up completely, you know. Escape, if they are fully clumped up and they get caught in a huge wombo combo from the sleep into Disrupt Royalty with Tombstone and everything on top, it can hurt them, but they should be obviously be aware of this in this type of game.
Era is going to be spinning away, not going to be netted, not going to be arrowed, but now he's and pretty much everything he can do. He's got an Omni Slash still, he's still got his Aegis. You can feel that Escape really want to push, but they're just lacking a little bit of that momentum. The Chen army slowly Trixie getting whittled down by Mirana arrows.
Trixie in position. They have three aggressive wards coming out for Escape, so they see Lota instantly make a move toward the mid lane. And yeah, they're watching all the movements outside of the base if the Alliance does try to do so. But yeah, keeping them at bay here at this bottom lane. Oh, the Kahn era.
It's going to be a spin, though. Juggernaut moving forward. He's real deep now. Can they punish this? The Song going to be coming in. It looks like they're setting up. They want to go into Juggernaut. The Tombstone dropping.
The combo.
The zombies are going to be coming through, rather. And there's the Static Storm. And we will see the Juggernaut lose his Aegis. Glimpse coming back in. Trixie's going in with that epicenter, but it's not really getting a whole lot done. But there is going to be the Hand of God. Now there's the reinitiation. Burrow Strike coming back in. The Sanity's doing some work. Axe is now dead. 45 seconds. It's so early in the game that no one has money for buyback. And Escape should be able to get some serious damage onto this tier 3.
The Tombstone actually tickled. It canceled the blink from the Sankin coming in from the top side, but other than that, it just really tickled and didn't really do too much.
Arrow
now
onto the Chen, gets him low, but that is just going to be Juggernaut coming in, swinging his sword, getting
no
the kill onto the Mirana. These racks are starting to go down. We're 18 minutes in, and it looks like this Naga lineup just wasn't given enough time to come online. Yeah. Of course, Alliance, they are no stranger to super creeps. They've come back from worse. I don't want to tap them out just yet, but it's feeling like Escape have found that window they need to get that early push online. And oh, there we go. There's the damage. OD laying into Handskin. And that Disruptor's gone for 30 more seconds. A lot of control now lacking. Escape looks like they're just going to be going straight in, carving up the mid lane. And Era, he's fine taking these tower shots. They've got Cinder in there to tank as well if necessary.
Yeah, this might actually just be it. They got their timings really well done by Yapsword's rotations. Era as well making the movement toward the bottom lane. Yep, Koifa too. Trixie definitely struggling a bit amount in this game, but the other three are making the moves and putting a lot of the pressure. But yeah, they get deterred a bit away from taking that second lane of Rax, and Lota should be able to finish up his Radiance quite soon.
I mean, is this enough? You see Alliance, they've made themselves a home in this top lane. It's pushed out. They've still got some chance to go and try to rat the tier threes. But it just seems like it might be too little too late as Escape. They've already got one lane of super creeps. They've started damage onto a second.
Yeah, I don't want to count out the Naga 100% just yet, but it's definitely really hard. He maybe has like a 30% chance or something like that to come back versus Escape's lineup, just because they have heroes that can deal with Naga illusions. Juggernaut's massive, OD a natural counter in a way. Same thing with the Sand King too, if he's ever able to get an Aghanim's. Still quite a ways away from that, obviously, but the other cores match up very well versus this Naga Siren. And,
man, look at that XP shirt, we got an M.
Like, Radiance is painful, but when the illusions are so squishy and you can clear them out with like one arcane orb or like a couple right clicks from the Juggernaut, it's not nearly as intimidating. Oh, definitely still got Alliance, still definitely has quite a ways left for them to come back into this game, but definitely not counting them out just entirely yet.
I mean, we talked earlier about how the key to this game is the Chen, and I think Yapsor has been performing fantastically. He had a great Axe timing. The Ancient's able to push in with that last oomph, really getting that first lane of Rax down. Now there's going to be an initiation onto a Naga illusion. They're not going to find exactly what they wanted, but just taking that thing out to deny as much vision to Alliance as possible.
Yeah, their smoke got broken by EGM on the high ground, and then the illusion was pretty much right there as EGM's running down, so they're like, oh, it's the real Naga because their smoke broke, but yeah, EGM was keen to just run away there.
The Alliance mind game, that's how they get you. Alliance just walking around. Again, they do still feel comfortable in the Dire top lane. They haven't been hunted there. There's really no escape vision. Escape are much more focused on being on the Radiant side of the map. So it is Alliance's comeback place. They're just keeping their heroes there. They've all got TPs if necessary. Now OD, he's not going back. He's building into some big juicy items now.
Yeah, they know the top lane's safe, but Yapsor is sending his creeps in the bottom lane to force that momentum much harder, and they're just going to be going toward that mid lane, going for that next set of racks ASAP. And Era, I like this build that he's doing too. He's going just straight up stats, just to be that like tanky frontliner for his OD to just be able to deal the damage in the backlines. Now, Yapsor has the mech finished up too. They have the Vlads on the Ogre too. It's go time. This is the is their time to shine, push the racks in. I don't think Alliance is ready for this.
I think Alliance, they've got to rotate back. You can tell they really want to split push, but this might be their last hold. Again, if Escape win this, we're going to a game at number 3. It's all going to come down to pretty much a best of 1 to determine the grand finals.
Double Wild Wing in the back. One gets taken out. Second one is well from an arrow.
Aww. Their corpses lie together. Now, Era just moving in. He really wants these racks. He's going to get netted up by the Naga Siren. Again, there is still the sleep available if Alliance want to go and try to set this fight up right. The call comes in. You're going to bait that taunt onto the Juggernaut. He's moving forward very deep into the fight. He's going to spin. So now that spin is down. Is it Alliance's time to strike? EGM goes into the Flesh Golem form. They are going to be able to go. They get the glimpse, but the Omni Slash to break up the fight. And oh, there's a great initiation from the Sand King. Static Storm connects onto 2, but is it enough? Double buybacks from Alliance. They cannot afford to lose any more heroes here. Era, he's still feeling safe. He still wants to move back up onto the high ground. Koikva, full health, full mana. He's going to be big and bloodlusted, and he is ready to fight.
Bit of a mistake there from EGM walking up, giving Era a target to Omni Slash so he doesn't get glimpsed all the way back into a bad position. He probably would have got an Astral, then at least like absorbed a little bit of that Static Storm damage, but still, definitely a slight misplay there from EGM from stepping up. And I mean, these slight misplays are very costly in this type of game. It's Alota just died, was forced to buy back, same thing with the Undying, so now their farm is completely stagnated.
Yeah, Alota's definitely having a lot of trouble getting online here, and of course, it is just so early on, you don't expect the Naga to have to fight this early now. Yona's doing everything he can just to keep himself alive. There is going to be a glimpse back here. Trixie could be in some trouble. Trixie may be the sacrificial lamb. Astral Imprisonment comes out. Tombstone going to be focused down by Koikva, who now moves in aggressively onto EGM. Just going through trying to clear up these creeps. There will be a Neps. BKB comes out from the OD, able to pick off the Axe. Axe immediately buys back Alliance. It's their go time. Hanskin killed off in 2 shots by the OD, and this time does not have buyback. The racks are starting to fall. Nirana just leaping back to safety. The net comes out, does connect onto the Jug. Can they fight this? Jonas goes deep, is able to dunk down Trixie, but...
Oh, Lotus just...
Oh, that's a dieback here.
It's 69 storm.
Oh, my goodness. It's a rampage coming out from Koikva. And that's going to be GG. We are going to a game number 3 as Alliance, at 23 minutes in the game, just get completely pulverized.
Yeah. Their game plan ended up working out very well with the rotations from Yapzor. I had a little bit of doubts in the Chen, but he shut me up completely, and I mean, excellent rotations from the whole team, and they just looked much crisper this game, and they had a game plan for the Naga, and it worked. It worked out.